Good day, children. Hope you all are fine. Today, let us go on with Unit 7, Prose, The Dying Detective, written by Arthur Conan Doyle, Part 2. Children, today we are going with Part 2, children. In Part 1, what have we seen? What have we read in Part 1? We read about Sherlock Holmes' sickness. How did he fell sick? Then how his friend came for his help. But Sherlock Holmes did not accept his friend to cure him. Then he locked Sherlock Holmes locked Watson in room for 2 hours. Later on he asked him to go and fetch Mr. Culbertson Smith of 13 Lower Burke Street. Now, let us continue, children. Here, Sherlock Holmes, he asked his friend to call Mr. Culbertson Smith of 13 Lower Burke Street. And what is Watson doing further on? Let us see. I was hesitant to leave him now. He was delirious. When Sherlock Holmes asked him to fetch Mr. Culbertson Smith, Watson, he was hesitating to leave Sherlock Holmes because he was delirious. What do you mean by delirious, children? Delirious in the sense, disturbed state of mind characterized by restlessness. Sherlock Holmes was sick, so Watson, he doesn't want to leave his friend. He was feeling, he was really hesitating to leave his friend and go. I have never heard of the name, I said. Well, he is the man who has the knowledge of this disease, but he is not a medical man. He is a planter. He lives in Sumatra, now visiting London. Watson, he said, I have not heard such a name in a doctor's list. I have not heard such a name. Sherlock Holmes, he says, well, he's not a doctor. He's not a medical man. But anyways, he has the knowledge of this disease. And he lives in Sumatra. He has visited to London. He's visiting London now. Actually, he lives in Sumatra. And now to the present time, he is here in London. I didn't want you to go before 6 because you won't have found him in his study. I hope you will be able to persuade him to come. You will tell him exactly how you left me, he said. You must tell him that I'm dying. Plead him, Watson. Sherlock Holmes, he says to Watson, he says, I asked you to go now because before 6, had you gone there, you would have not found him there. That's why I asked you to wait here for 2 hours and I'm telling you to go now. If you go now, for sure he'll be there. And Sherlock Holmes, he says, request him and tell him how you have left me here. Exactly tell him in what state I am. Tell him I am dying. You request him. You see that he comes here to my place. Sherlock Holmes, he's conveying everything this to Watson. He wants Watson somehow to bring Mr. Culbertson Smith. He wants Culbertson Smith to come to his residence. To whose residence? Sherlock Holmes' residence. I'll bring him in a cab, I said. No, you will persuade him to come and return before him. Make any excuse. Remember this, Watson. Watson says, don't worry, Holmes. For sure, I'll bring him along with me. I'll bring him in a cab. And Sherlock Holmes says, no, I don't want you to bring him along with you. You come here before he could come. You come here and leave the place. I don't want you to come along with him. Let him come alone. And I want you in the sense to Watson, he says, Watson, I want you to, you go convey this message to Smith and come here come see me and leave the place before Smith comes to my place. Okay. I saw Mrs. Hudson was waiting outside, trembling and crying below as I waited for the cab. I met Inspector Morton of the Scotland Yard. He was not in his uniform. Now, after taking all the instruction from Sherlock Holmes, Watson, he leaves Sherlock Holmes' house and he was about to take the cab. He comes down from his house. He was waiting for the cab. As he was waiting for the cab, he sees Mrs. Hudson. Who is Hudson? Sherlock Holmes' landlady. Okay. Mrs. Hudson, no, she was waiting outside, trembling, crying badly. Why is she crying? To the situation of Sherlock Holmes, looking at the illness of Sherlock Holmes, no, she is crying badly. And over there, no, even Watson was also waiting for the cab. Why he was waiting for the cab? To fetch, to meet Mrs. Culbertson. He must go to the residence of Culbertson Smith, no? So he was waiting for the cab. As he was waiting for the cab, at that time, he met Inspector of Scotland, Mr. Morton. He met Mr. Morton. Who is Morton? He is the Inspector of Scotland Yard. Now, Inspector is getting inside Sherlock Holmes' house to see him. And one more thing, Morton is not in his uniform. He is not in his inspector dress. He's in mufti dress. How is he? Asked Inspector Morton. He is very ill, I answered. Now Morton is asking Watson. Watson, how is Sherlock Holmes? Morton says he is very ill. Morton, his condition is very bad. I reached Mr. Culbertson Smith house. The butler appeared at the doorway through the half open door. I heard a man's voice telling the butler, I am not at home, say so. I pushed past the butler and entered the room. Now, I saw a frail man with bald head sitting. I am sorry, I said, but the matter cannot be delayed, Mr. Sherlock Holmes. Okay. Here, no, Culbertson Smith, somehow he reaches, Watson, he reaches Culbertson Smith house. The moment he reaches Culbertson house, no, the butler appears over there at the doorway. And the doorway, no, children, it's half open. Over there, Watson, he hears the voice telling butler, to ask the man to say that he's not there at home. And the butler also, he repeats the same thing. Master is not at home. The moment when butler says this, master is not at home, Watson, he pushes him and he gets inside the house. Forcefully he gets inside the house. The moment he enters the house, he sees a frail man. What do you mean by frail man, children? A weak and delicate man with bald head. What do you mean by bald head? Where there is no hair on head, okay, where you don't have hair on head, no, it's known as bald head. He goes inside and he says, I'm sorry, sir, but I have to meet you. It is very urgent. I cannot delay the matter. No, it's because Sherlock Holmes, the moment he says Sherlock Holmes, no, he stops over there. He says, Sherlock Holmes, he's sick. That's what he mean to say. Sherlock Holmes, no? It is understood. Children, see, you could see Watson and Culbertson Smith meeting each other. No, Watson is saying the condition of Holmes to Culbertson Smith. Okay. The mere mention of his name had a different effect on the man. Have you come from Holmes? How is he? He asked. The moment Watson, he said, Sherlock Holmes, as he dragged, Culbertson Smith, he understood. The man has come from Sherlock Holmes. From him he has come, he understood. And he asked, Culbertson Smith asked him, how is Holmes? He asked. He is very ill. That is why I have come here, Mr. Holmes. He has a high opinion of you and thought you are the only man in London who can help him? The little man was startled. Why? He asked. Now when Culverts and Smith inquired about the health of Holmes, no, Watson says he is very ill, no, his condition is very bad and he has high opinion of you and he thinks that only you can help him in entire London, only you can cure him, no one else can cure him. The little man, no, he was startled. Who is startled over here? Watson, no, he was startled. Startled in the cell, felt sudden shock or alarm. He was shocked. Smith was shocked, no, the moment he heard the illness of Sherlock Holmes, he was shocked. And when he said only he can help him, no, he was really, he started thinking. And he asked, why? Is that only I could help him? Why not others could cure him? Because of your knowledge of the Eastern disease, I replied. How did he get it? He asked. I told him everything. He smiled and agreed to come. Pretending that I had some other appointment, I left him with a sinking heart. I reached Holmes' room. I told him that Mr. Smith was coming. When Culverts and Smith, he asked, how come only I could cure him? No other doctor could cure him. Nah? He said, Watson, he said, see, you know, you have better knowledge of this disease. That's why Holmes said that only you could cure him. And no, Culverts and Smith, he asked him, how did he get this disease? How did Holmes get this disease? He said, no, everything, what happened to him, everything, no, he narrated to Culverts and Smith. And Culverts and Smith, no, he smiled and he agreed, okay, I'll come. Now, after his agreement, no, Watson, he pretended that as if, no, he has some great appointment. He said, sir, I'm busy. I have some appointment, so I shall leave. And you shall go and meet Holmes. Saying that, he left. He left the house of Culverts and Smith. He went to Sherlock Holmes and he said, what all happened? He said, I met Smith and Smith is on the way. He's coming. Very soon he'll be here. He informed to Sherlock Holmes. Well done, Watson, he said. You have done everything that a good friend could do. Now, you disappear to the next room and don't speak or come here. After Watson has narrated everything, no, Sherlock Holmes was very happy. He said, very good, Watson. What all I asked you to do, you have done. You are really a good friend, Watson. Now, don't be here. You be in the next room. You just be over there. Don't speak and don't come out. Who said this to whom? Sherlock Holmes asked Watson to be inside the room and he asked him not to come out. I heard the footsteps. I heard a voice say, Holmes, Holmes, can you hear me? Is that you, Mr. Smith? Holmes whispered, you know what is wrong with me. You are the only one in London who can cure me. Now Smith, he enters Sherlock Holmes' house. The moment he enters the house, no, he gives the voice, no, he calls, Holmes, Holmes, can you hear me? The moment Holmes heard Smith's voice, he said, yes, Smith, very slowly, he said, yes, Smith, come in. You know what is my problem and this entire London, only you can cure me, Smith. I beg you to cure me. He keeps saying to Culverts and Smith, who says this? Sherlock Holmes says to Smith, do you know the symptoms? Asked Smith. Only too well, Mr. Smith. And he described the symptoms. They are the same, Holmes, Smith said. Poor Victor was a dead man on the fourth day, a strong and healthy young man. What a coincidence indeed. Now, Smith, no, he's asking Holmes, what's the symptoms? Children, obviously, when we have a fever, no, we'll have certain symptoms. No, our body goes hot, our eyes become red, and no, we feel giddiness. All the symptoms, no, fever symptoms. The same way, the disease what Holmes has, Smith is asking, what is the symptoms? How do you feel? Everything, no? He has the symptoms. And after asking the symptoms, he makes sure, yes, he is affected by contagious disease. He is affected. He makes sure. Now, no, Holmes, Smith, he says, poor Victor, no? Even he died, a very strong and healthy young man. Even he died after infected by this disease. Hardly 4 days he was alive and he passed away. Poor fellow, he says. Who says this? Smith says to Holmes. I know that you did it, said Holmes. Well, you can't prove it. Give me water, please, Holmes groaned. Now, no, Sherlock Holmes, he said. I know, Smith, it is you who did it. It is you who was the cause for poor Victor's death, Holmes says. And Culverton Smith says, well, that is right, but you cannot prove, Holmes. You cannot prove that I killed him. You cannot prove. Okay, anyways, give me some water, Holmes asks Smith. No, he kept water over there on the table. He said, please, Smith, give me some water. Here, I heard Smith's voice. Cure me, please. Well, about Victor Savage's death, you did it. I'll forget everything, but cure me. I'll forget about it. Now, Holmes, he says, okay, Smith, see, it is you who did the murder of poor Victor. Okay, you are the cause for the murder of Victor. And anyways, no, you cure. If you cure me, for sure, I'll forget the incident. What happened? How did you kill Victor Savage? I'll forget that, but do cure me, you know, he requested. Please, Smith, cure me. I want to live. Cure me, he started begging. Who is begging whom? Holmes is begging to Culverton Smith. You can forget or remember just as you like. It doesn't matter to me how my nephew died. Watson said, you got it from the Chinese sailor. Could there be any other reason? Now, actually, who is this Victor in the sense? Victor is the cousin of Smith. Okay. Children, even you have a cousin, no, children. Your auntie's children, your uncle's children. They are all cousin brothers, sisters. Okay, the same way. Victor is cousin of Smith. And Victor, he killed Smith. I mean, Victor, he is the cousin of Smith. Both are cousins. And Smith is the cause for the death of Victor. And this was known only to Sherlock Holmes. Okay. Now Sherlock Holmes, Smith, he says, see, I don't mind either you remember or you don't remember, either you know or you don't know how Victor died. I'm least bothered of this. I don't mind about this. Smith, no, he says, he's saying to Sherlock Holmes, Watson, he said that you have got this disease from a Chinese sailor. Could there be any other reason? Is it only from Chinese sailor was this disease infected to you? Or any other reason? By some other means were you infected? I can't think. My mind is gone. Help me, pleaded Holmes. Did anything come by post? A box by chance on Wednesday. Now when he asked how did you get this disease or no? Holmes says, see, I don't remember actually how I got this disease. Totally, no, my mind is gone. I am out of mind now. Now, please help me, Smith. Holmes, no, he is requesting Smith. Smith, please help me, cure me. He keeps requesting him. Now, Smith is asking, did you get anything in parcel? You know, a small box like that. Did you get anything by post? Smith is asking to Holmes. Yes, I opened it and there was a sharp spring inside it. A joke, perhaps. It drew blood, said Holmes. Holmes, he said, yes, I got a small box by parcel. I received a small box and inside the box there was a spring. You know, the spring, the moment you open the spring, no, there is all possibilities to get your finger cut. You know, it drew blood. No, it was not a joke, you fool. You have got it. Who asked you to cross my path? You know too much about Victor's death. Your end is near, Holmes. I'll carry this box in my pocket. The last piece of evidence. And no, Holmes says, it is just a joke. Perhaps the box contains just a spring. No, it is like funny thing it was. For that, Smith says, it is not a joke, fool. You are a great fool over here. It is, the box is not a joke. And who asked you to cross my path? Now, who asked you to interfere in all my deeds? No, you know everything about Victor's death. And it is only you who know that I have killed Victor, only you who know. And you are on your deathbed. Very soon you will also die. And this box is the last evidence of Victor's death. So I'll carry this box. Saying this, no, Culbertson Smith, he carries the box because he knows that box is the evidence for Victor's death. He tried to carry the box along with him. Turn up the gas, Smith, said Holmes in his natural voice. Yes, I'll so, that I can see you better. There was silence. Then I heard Smith say, what's all this? Now, Holmes says, he had that gas lamp, isn't it? Now, Holmes says, turn up the gas lamp, Smith. He kept in half. Now, he's asking Smith, turn full. That is, I want full brightness from the gas lamp. He's asking him to turn the gas lamp. And now this time, no, when Holmes he spoke to Smith, he spoke in his natural voice in the sense, in a very bold voice. And Smith says, yes, I'll do it. No, saying so, when he turned, he brought the lamp to its full brightness. There was silent for some time. No, there was silent. Then I heard Smith said, what is this all? Successful acting, said Holmes. For 3 days, I didn't taste anything, neither food nor drink. The moment he turned the lamp to its full brightness, the lamp, it glowed to the full brightness, where he could see Holmes, very near he could see Holmes. And Holmes, no, he doesn't seem to be that much sick. No, he sat as a common man, no, he sat straight. Now, Smith is asking, what is this, Holmes? Holmes said, it is all successful acting, Smith. For 3 days, I did not eat nor I drink anything. There was footsteps outside the door open and I heard Inspector Morton's voice. I arrest you on charge of murder, he said. The very moment, no, from next door, Morton, no, even the inspector was hidden in the next door. He heard all the dialogues, what was spoken by Holmes and Smith. He arrested Smith. No, he said, inspector said, you are under arrest, Smith, for murdering Victor. You are under arrest. Children, actually what happens in the sense, here Smith, no, he's the cousin of Victor, and he's the one to murder Victor. After killing Victor, you know, he thought of hiding the entire evidence. He doesn't want to get caught. And this was, it was brought out by Holmes. Now, Holmes, how to make Victor say, make Smith say that he has murdered Victor? So this all was a planning done by Holmes. Actually, Holmes was not sick. He acted. This was all an acting. And none know this, that Holmes was all right. He is totally fit. He is just acting. None know this. Okay. See, Mr. Morton is arresting Smith. No, you could see, children. No, you can see the picture. Okay. If so, let me bring Sir Japs, Jaspek, Meek, or Fenrose Fish, or Holmes. There was a sudden rush and scuffle, followed by the clash of iron and sudden cry of pain. There was a click of handcuffs. Holmes asked me to come in. Now, no, the moment when the inspector, no, who was hidden inside the room, when he heard everything that was said by Smith, that he has murdered Victor, when he said, very soon, no, inspector came out of the room and, no, he arrested him. And entire room was silent, only the clicking sound, the handcuff sound, the locking sound, no. I mean, when you arrest any criminal, no children, you get that sound, the click of the handcuff sound you get, only that was heard. Now, Holmes asked me to come in. Whom? He's asking Watson. Even Watson was hidden inside the room. No, he asked Watson also to come out of the room. Sorry, Watson, I was rude to you. I undermined your capability as a doctor. It was just to get Smith here. And I didn't want you to know that I was not ill. Now, the moment Watson come, no, Holmes says, Watson, I'm very sorry. I underestimated you. I really insulted you, saying that you are not a practitioner. You are not a specialist. Which means, I know that you will really do well, Watson. And why didn't I allow you to cure me, in the sense, the moment you come near to me, somehow you will know that I'm totally fit. I'm not sick. You will come to know. And I don't want you to know this. That is why I had to underestimate you. Anyways, I'm sorry, Watson. No, he says this to, Holmes says to Watson. But your appearance, I said, 3 days fasting and the makeup did the trick. The coins, oh, that was only to prove that I was delirious. He laughed. I need to eat now, Watson. Mr. Smith killed his nephew and he want to kill me the same way and avoid imprisonment. I needed to eat now, Watson. Okay. Now he's asking, no, Watson's asking, then how about your appearance? Your appearance was, no, it showed that you were so sick. How about this all? For that, Holmes says, nothing, Watson, it is only 3 days fasting and little bit makeup, no, this made a trick. And okay, now, no, they laughed after listening to this all. No, they started laughing. And no, he said, see, Mr. Smith, he killed Victor and he really want to escape from imprisonment. And the way how he killed Victor, the same way he planned to kill me also. So to bring out the criminal, I had to go up with all this acting. I really want to put him under bars. That is why I went on with all this makeup and acting, he said. Now, I need to eat now, Watson. I think that something nutritious at Simpson would not be out of place. And thank you, Watson, he said. Now, no, Holmes said, I'm really hungry. I really wish to eat something good. And anyways, Watson, thank you very much, he said. Nice, no, children? Very nice story this is. Okay, now let us see about the author, children. The authors are Arthur Ignatius Conan Doyle. Born in 1859 and died in 1930, was a British writer best known for his detective fiction featuring the character of Sherlock Holmes, which are generally considered milestones in the field of crime fiction. Yes, children, has know this story, so Sherlock Holmes stories, it really gave name and fame to Conan Doyle. It took him to the milestone in the field of crime fiction, children. Sherlock Holmes stories, no, children, for sure, when you come across any story, no, do read it. You will enjoy it. You will relish reading it, children. For sure, no, young children will love Sherlock Holmes stories. All these crime stories, no, children, and how the crime was brought forward. It is really thrilling to read, children. When you come across Sherlock Holmes stories, no, for sure, you read it. Doyle wrote 46 short stories featuring the famous detective. The story is narrated by the character Dr. Watson, originally a physician. In 1887, he published a study in Scarlet, the first of four novels about Holmes and Dr. Watson. Okay, so Dr. Watson and Sherlock Holmes stories, no children, it is really very familiar novels. And his first four novels about Holmes and Dr. Watson, it added to his fame. Doyle wrote over 50 stories featuring the famed detectives. Children, this detective stories, he wrote 50 stories. The Sherlock Holmes stories are generally considered milestone in the field of fiction. His notable work includes stories of Sherlock Holmes, The Lost War. He has done many work, children, but his notable work, the works that made him familiar is Sherlock Holmes. He became much popular on this Sherlock Holmes stories and The Lost War. This two novels, children, it brought him to his name and fame. Yes, children, I hope you would have understood the story, children. The story is very interesting. For sure, you will love the story, children. Do read the story. I really want you to read the lesson, children. Unless you read the lesson, that will not be clear to you, children. After my explanation, you must read the lesson. For sure, you must read the lesson, children. Do read it.